Greetings to you, students, faculty, and staff of the School of Theology and Seminary. We welcome you here to the second semester of this very unusual year. Obviously, all of us would much rather be gathered in the Emmaus Chapel at this point and to share in community fellowship, etc., afterwards. But this is what we are here dealing with. Fortunately, we do have a way to communicate with one another and to keep alive our bonds and to advance them in certain ways. So this evening we will begin with a prayer service, and simply want you to know how much it is vital and important to all of us to have you participating in our community. We treasure the pursuit of wisdom. We long for having many hands, many minds contribute towards this way of discipleship of Christ. And so, as we have heard in our country over the last 3-4 weeks, that it is important for us to stand in solidarity with one another and to rise up over all that is that divides us. And of course, that was the message of Jesus, which he summed up in the two greatest commandments: love the Lord your God above all, with everything you have within you, and to love your neighbor as yourself. So in this sense of solidarity and wanting to build bridges to make connections with one another, let us move into this new semester recognizing that we may stand now on a kind of time like the Holy Saturday, in which the experience of darkness has dominated, but we're in that in-between period where we look forward and anticipate this rising up and this coming to new life again.
Laudate Dominum de Celis. Benedictus est Domine Deus Patrum Nostrorum, et laudabilis et super exaltatus in saecula, et benedictum nomen gloriae tuae sanctum, et laudabilis et super exaltatus in saecula. Laudate Dominum de Celis. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Laudate Dominum de Celis.
O God, come to my assistance. Lord, make haste to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia.
God, take my grace, and grace, and love, and Mwenyezi Mungu ni mwema na mnyofu, kwa hiyo huwafundisha wenye dhambi njia, huwaongoza wanyenyekevu katika uadilifu, naam, huwafundisha hao njia yake.
The Lord is my light, the Lord is my light, the Lord is my light, and my salvation. The Lord is my light, the Lord is my light, the Lord is my light, and my salvation.
Reading from the first letter of Peter. For Christ also suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. In it he also went to preach to the spirits in prison, who had once been disobedient, while God patiently waited in the days of Noah during the building of the ark, in which a few persons, eight in all, were saved through water. This prefigured baptism, which saves you now, it is not a removal of dirt from the body, but an appeal to God for a clear conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers subject to him.
Sing to my
Gathering as an online community, we will now share our prayer petitions with one another. I invite you to type your intentions into the comments on your screen for all of us to hold in prayer. Let us pray for all leaders and ministers in all the churches. For whom shall we pray?
We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all those involved at all levels of education, formation, and scholarship. For what shall we pray?
We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for God's reign of justice and for all who are victims of any sort of injustice. For what shall we pray?
We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all who are sick in mind, body, or spirit. For whom shall we pray?
We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember our loved ones who have died. For whom shall we pray?
We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Gathering our prayers into one, let us unite our voices as we sing the words Jesus gave us.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your
Let us pray. O Lord, you have taught us that without love, whatever we do is worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts your greatest gift, which is love, the true bond of peace and all virtue. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us go forth to live faithful lives of love and service.
Thank you.